Good evening. Welcome to Champlain College. Prior to starting this evening, I would just like to make everybody aware of the evacuation procedures in case of an emergency. Guests seated in the bleachers, located at the back of the room and on the chairs to my left, are to exit at the door on that left-hand side. People sitting in the black chairs to my right would exit out the back on the right. Thank you very much and have a good evening.
Thank you. Remember all this stuff, eh? Throw something at me halfway through, so it's not during the speech, though. That's
legit.
No, and it's, yeah, I'm just going to tell everybody.
Good evening. Clearly my assistant has a sense of humor because she put my name in the inside of my program in case I got nervous. I'm Don Schuin, I'm the campus director here, welcome. If you are not wearing a blue cap and gown, which means you guys stay seated, would the rest of you stand up for a minute? We're gonna start this off right. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our graduating class for 2018. So now, if you'd all have a seat. Struck me while they were all standing that if you guys were difficult to live with before, God help them, you're going to be more difficult now. Thoughtless applause and affection and everything else you're going to get tonight. It's been over 10 years that I've had the privilege of standing up at a graduation and talking. And you know, it struck me there's one thing I never get tired of saying. Champlain graduate. I really am extremely proud that I've managed to devote most of my career to Champlain. And first and foremost, it's because we graduate good people. And that's you guys. Tonight, you can applaud for them anytime you want. Tonight, you form the bridge between the people who have come before you and those who are going to follow in a proud and growing tradition. And you have a role there. And that's to show the way to the people that you had in classes this year who aren't here tonight. It's to encourage them in whatever way you can. And it is to help them remember that there is a moment of pride of wearing a blue Champlain cap and gown. J'aimerais remercier et féliciter vous qui ont choisi de poursuivre vos études en anglais au Collège Champlain. Nous apprécions la confiance que vous et vos parents nous avez accordée. Étudier dans une langue seconde demande de la motivation, de la persévérance et de la patience. La fierté de votre réussite nous touche chacun et chacune. Now, one of the things that I'm particularly proud of this year is our growing relationship with our friends and neighbors in Ganawage. Yeah.
I want to thank you for investing your time and energy in making us better, mostly better human beings. Thank you for the privilege that you've given us of being here on your ancestral land and the opportunity we have to use it to help to build bonds together. Thank you. It is my sincere hope that the seeds that we've planted this year, or replanted in some cases, are going to grow into something quite magnificent. And that as the years go by, we'll see what it means to build that kind of bond between our institutions, our peoples, and all of the things that we can do together. Now, I need to take a minute to thank a few people. And the first is to the parents, and to the families, and to the friends, all of the people who've lent a helping hand, the ones who, it sounds kind of corny, but the ones who love you enough to help you at the worst of times, to pick you up when you fall down, to tell you that it is okay not to do things just perfectly, but we're still proud of you. And so to all of you who have contributed to these fine folks being here tonight, please accept our deepest thanks. You make a difference to them, even when they don't remember to tell you. Clearly that had an impact. You know, I think it is safe to say there's not a single graduate here tonight who could honestly claim that her or his success was only due to their own individual effort. There's an incredible team, an all-star team of women and men who teach, who support, who guide, who counsel, who lead, who inspire our students, who are the bedrock on which their success is built. And so, all of you who are there and some of you who are out in the audience, thank you. You've made it possible for them to be here tonight. And we all appreciate that. Thank you. Now, it's quite a year to attempt to make a grad speech. To say that the world is a better place than when you started at Champlain, I suspect, would be a gross exaggeration. This year alone, we've had the Me Too movement. We've had shootings in schools which are at an all-time high. We have relations with our neighbors to the south that have soured over trade, and the list goes on and on and on. There seems to be an increase of natural disasters. There's more and bigger hurricanes and cyclones. There's increased flooding, and there's violent volcanoes that are threatening lives, and on and on. And of course, I guess I could be accused of being very depressing on a night of celebration. So, what are we to do? Well, I was going to start my speech by saying that I am a dreamer. And I know, I said, how nice for me. The thing is that I'm certain that most of the rest of you have dreams too. In fact, you are part of one of my dreams, and that is to build a great college. It's a college that's not measured by the number of buildings we have. It's not measured by the size of our enrollment or our budgets. I mean a college where we measure the quality of the women and men we graduate, in how we encourage them not just to dream, not just to make their dreams come true, but to encourage and inspire them to have dreams that actually do something for others and that make this world a better place. Because goodness knows we need it. You know, I like how Oprah Winfrey put it. The key to realizing a dream is to focus not on success, but on significance. And then even the small steps and the little victories along your path take on greater meaning. Now, here's something I'd like you to consider when you think about your dreams. Very rarely are important things achieved in a vacuum. As I said earlier, your graduation's a team effort. You, your family, our staff and faculty, and others. No, to apply that to your biggest dreams. By the way, Can I encourage you to dream big? You are capable of more than you realize, more than you give yourselves credit for. So why limit the scope of your reach? A big dream partially achieved is still greater than a small one that's boxed in and stifled. Now, earlier I talked about school shootings, and one of the most striking events for me in the past year was the student movement that grew after the terrible shootings in Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School in Parkland, Florida. It is a travesty that it took a bunch of high school students to raise the issue of gun control and safety to a level that adults should have done well before. But that case is highly instructive. You're going to have dreams, terrific ones, but your chances of realizing them are going to grow exponentially if you're capable of working with others. One student in that case would have been an isolated voice. Oh, that's, you know, he really cares, and that's nice. But that initial handful of students has become a movement. It has started to focus a change on an issue that needs dealing with, not just in the United States, but here as well. So think about them and learn something from them. Because you guys are a little older, but not that much. You know, there are a lot of people who'd like to dismiss you. Ah, who are they? But the truth is, you can change the world. So now, just when you thought you were finished with school and with Champlain for a while, and most definitely with homework, I want to challenge you to do some over the summer. I would like you to give yourselves time to think about what's important to you. What are your dreams and aspirations? How can you bring your talent to bear to make this planet a better place? And in that regard, I'd like to share with you a piece of advice from Tim Cook, president of Apple. In describing our relentless search for purpose, he said, "The truth is that we all have the same purpose, so we should all quit looking. Our purpose is to serve humanity." Wait, what? So we should all just stop looking? Keep in mind that Cook himself mentioned it took him 15 years to define his purpose in life, which I guess means he must have been searching for a meaningful purpose throughout an awful lot of his career. But, you know, it's kind of surprising. That comes from the president of a major corporation, but his advice makes sense if you think about it. First, we're all such different people, but this idea of serving humanity is universal, and it can be applied to an infinite amount of ways. And second, focusing on serving the collective good actually helps us to get a healthy dose of perspective and live a more fulfilling life on an individual level. I want to share with you a small portion of what for me is the greatest speech about dreams ever given. Of course, it's the one by Dr. Martin Luther King. And he said, "I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal." A little later on, he said, "I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character." And now I'd like to take the liberty of observing that if Dr. King were alive today, he might have said it just slightly differently. All women and men are created equal. And that people, not only his children, will be judged not by the color of their skin, not by their ethnic background, not by their gender or language, not by anything but the content of their character. And I included Dr. King's speech because in him we saw a man who did exactly what I was trying to talk about. He made real and concrete steps to making his dream a reality. Sadly, his dream was too big to come true in a single lifetime. For as long as we humans to allow our lesser selves to rule over us, it won't be fully achieved. But what he did was move forward by giant steps that some part of it was coming true. Now, I suspect that probably none of you, and certainly I, will never be a Dr. King. But I'm also certain that we can turn dreams into a reality, or at least try. So now, if the first piece of homework for you is to allow yourself some time to think about your dreams, the second is more challenging. Not going to make me too popular with you guys, but hey, it's what we need to think about. Never do I want you to diminish the value of thinking. But you know, I'm reminded that one of the definitions of a dreamer is a person who's impractical and idealistic. So the second piece is that dream that I asked you to think about, what it is that's in your head and your heart. I want you to take it and make at least one or two small steps this summer to making it come true. And now here's what I propose. If you'll agree to do this, I will too. And if any of you are interested, at the end of the summer, we can compare notes. You can send me a meal. Let's check up with each other. See how we did. And you know, I get you in trouble perhaps with the rest of them out there, but I wonder if you would agree that we should offer this same challenge to all of the other people in this gymnasium. Maybe they want to do that. They want to think about their dreams. They want to do one or two small things to make them come true. So, if you think that that's worth doing, you feel free to share the challenge with them throughout the summer. You feel free to tell them what you've done, what you thought about, and what you've achieved, and ask them how they're doing. They probably won't thank you for it at the first, but I'll bet you by the time you're done, they will. And so on that note, I want to thank each of you.